खुशी कौन नहीं चाहता, लेकिन किस कीमत पर? धूम्रपान महंगा पड़ता है। धूम्रपान आपके लिए हानिकारक है और आपके चाहने वालों के लिए भी। धूम्रपान पड़ेगा महंगा।
हेलो दोस्तों, मैं आपका हार्दिक स्वागत करती हूँ मेरे यूट्यूब चैनल सिनेमा रिव्यूज में। आज के इस वीडियो में मैं बात करने वाली हूँ बॉलीवुड की सुपरहिट मूवी बर्फी के बारे में, जो कि टॉप 10 मूवी में आती है, जो एक रियल स्टोरी पे आधारित मूवी है। तो चलो शुरू करते हैं मूवी का रिव्यू।
मेन मेन्यू विकिपीडिया, फ्री एनसाइक्लोपीडिया, सर्च विकिपीडिया, क्रिएट अकाउंट, लॉग इन, पर्सनल टूल्स, कंटेंट्स हाइड, टॉप प्लॉट, टॉगल प्लॉट सबसेक्शन, 1972 1978 2012 कास्ट, प्रोडक्शन, टॉगल प्रोडक्शन सबसेक्शन, डेवलपमेंट, कास्टिंग, कैरेक्टर्स, फिल्मिंग, साउंडट्रैक, मार्केटिंग एंड रिलीज, टॉगल मार्केटिंग एंड रिलीज सबसेक्शन, कंट्रोवर्सीज, रिसेप्शन, टॉगल रिसेप्शन सबसेक्शन, इंडिया, ओवरसीज, एक्लेड्स, बॉक्स ऑफिस। सी आल्सो रेफरेंसेस, एक्सटर्नल लिंक्स, बर्फी आर्टिकल, टॉक, रीड, एडिट, व्यू हिस्ट्री, टूल्स, दिस इज अ गुड आर्टिकल, क्लिक हियर फॉर मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन। फ्रॉम विकिपीडिया द फ्री एनसाइक्लोपीडिया, दिस आर्टिकल इज अबाउट द 2012 हिंदी फिल्म। फॉर द 2013 कनाडा फिल्म सी बर्फी फिल्म। फॉर द साउथ एशियन स्वीट सी बर्फी। बर्फी, one man and two women sit on an old wooden bench smiling at the camera with fields of Darjeeling in the background. The title, director, producer and distributor information is printed across the top. Text at the bottom of the poster reveals the release date and the rest of the credits. Theatrical release poster, directed by Anurag Basu, written by story and screenplay Anurag Basu. Dialogues, Sanjeev Datta, co-writer, Tani Basu, produced by Ronnie Screwvala, Siddharth Roy Kapoor, starring Ranbir Kapoor, Priyanka Chopra, Aliana D. Cruz, narrated by Aliana D. Cruz, J.T. Bhatia, Saurabh Shukla, Bhola Raj Sapkota, cinematography Ravi Vaman, edited by Akiv Ali, music by Pritham, production, companies, Ishana Movies, UTV Motion Pictures, distributed by UTV Motion Pictures. Release date, the 14th of September 2012. Running time 150 minutes. Country India. Language Hindi. Budget 35 crore rupees, 1. Box office 175 crore rupees, 2. Barfi is a 2012 Indian Hindi language romantic comedy drama film written and directed by Anurag Basu, edited by Akiv Ali, and produced by Ronnie Screwvala and Siddharth Roy Kapoor under the UTV Motion Pictures banner. The film stars Ranbir Kapoor as the eponymous lead with Priyanka Chopra and Aliana D. Cruz, while Saurabh Shukla, Ashish Vidyarthi, Haradhan Bandopadhyay and Jishu Sengupta play supporting roles. Set in 1970s Darjeeling in Kolkata, the film is about Murphy, Barfi Johnson, a deaf-mute young boy who develops a special bond with two young girls, while often being chased by a local police officer for his nuisances. Made on a total budget of 35 crore rupees, Barfi opened worldwide in cinemas on the 14th of September 2012. The film received critical acclaim, praising the cast performances, direction, screenplay, cinematography, music and the portrayal of physically disabled people. The film turned out to be a major commercial success, becoming one of the highest grossing Bollywood films of 2012 in India and overseas, and accumulated 175 crore rupees worldwide. Since its release, Barfi has achieved a cult status. The film was selected as India's official entry for the Best Foreign Language Film nomination for the 85th Academy Awards. Barfi won several awards and nominations at various award ceremonies across India. At the 58th Filmfare Awards, Barfi received a leading 12 nominations, including Best Director, Basu, Best Actress, Chopra, and Best Supporting Actress, Dee Cruz, and won a leading 7 awards, including Best Film, Best Actor, Kapoor, Best Female Debut, Dee Cruz, and Best Music Director, Pritham. Plot. 1972. Murphy, Barfi, Johnson is a young boy who lives in Darjeeling and is known as a troublemaker as he cuts down street lampposts or plays practical jokes on innocent people and is often chased by Inspector Sudhanshu Datta. Soon, Barfi meets Shruti Ghosh, an educated young girl who is new in Darjeeling. He is smitten by her heavenly beauty and charm, thus falling in love with her. However, Shruti's mother advises her over avoiding to marry him due to his disabilities and lack of money. Shruti unwillingly agrees to her mother's advice, marries Ranjit Singh Gupta, and leaves Darjeeling, breaking all contact with Barfi. Shortly after Shruti's departure, Barfi's father suffers from kidney failure and is hospitalized, and Barfi is asked to arrange 7,000 rupees for his surgery. Meanwhile, Barfi's autistic childhood friend Jhilmil Chatterjee suddenly gets kidnapped and her wealthy father Durjoy Chatterjee asks Inspector Datta to search for her. After an unsuccessful attempt of robbing a local bank, Barfi finds Jhilmil in an abandoned van and drives away along with her. He hides her in his apartment and sends a 7,000 rupees ransom note to Jhilmil's family. Her father hands over the ransom to Barfi, but his father unfortunately dies just after he makes the hospital payment. A dejected Barfi leaves Jhilmil at her caretaker's house, but she refuses to stay over there and makes him take her away from there. Later, Barfi cleverly escapes from Inspector Datta along with Jhilmil and the two soon move to Kolkata. 1978. 6 years later, Barfi unexpectedly reunites with Shruti, who is unhappy with her marriage with Ranjit. She rekindles her friendship with Barfi and they begin to grow closer again, much to the jealousy of Jhilmil, who then goes missing. Shruti files a missing report of Jhilmil in the police. Soon, Inspector Datta learns about Jhilmil's disappearance, travels to Kolkata, and bumps into Barfi. After a comedic and entertaining chase, Inspector Datta manages to arrest Barfi and take him to Darjeeling. Over there, another demand of ransom is made during the process of interrogation at the police station. However, Jhilmil is apparently killed during the exchange of the ransom, even though her dead body is not found. The police frame Barfi for Jhilmil's murder in order to conclude the case. Inspector Datta, who grew fond of Barfi after chasing him for his nuisances, asks Shruti to take him away, offering him a second chance in life. Shruti takes Barfi back to Kolkata, hoping that she can now finally be with him due to the loss of Jhilmil. However, Barfi discovers Jhilmil's special care home address from the scribbles that she had made at his house. He takes Shruti at the special care home, where it is revealed that both the kidnappings of Jhilmil were fabricated by her father in order to embezzle much money from her trust fund. In his second attempt, he faked her death to let her live in the special care home, away from her alcoholic mother. Barfi and Jhilmil have a happy reunion over there and the two end up getting married. 2012. 34 years later, an elderly Barfi is shown to be severely ill in the hospital, where Jhilmil lies with him on the hospital bed and they die together. Shruti narrates how they died peacefully, not wanting to leave each other behind in life or death. The film ends with the happy days of Barfi and Jhilmil being shown and the credits roll. Cast. रणबीर कपूर इज मर्फी जन बहादुर जॉनसन ए के ए बर्फी, प्रियंका चोपड़ा इज झिलमिल दुर्जॉय चैटर्जी, अलियाना डी क्रूज इज श्रुति घोष श्रुति रंजीत सेन गुप्ता, सौरभ शुक्ला इज इंस्पेक्टर सुधांशु दत्ता, आशीष विद्यार्थी इज दुर्जॉय चैटर्जी झिलमिल फादर, आकाश खुराना इज जंग बहादुर जॉनसन बर्फी फादर, चिशु सेनगुप्ता इज रंजीत सेनगुप्ता श्रुति फियांसे टर्न्ड हस्बैंड, रूपा गांगुली इज मिसेस घोष श्रुतिज मदर, उदय टिकेकर इज मिस्टर घोष श्रुतिज फादर, सुमोना चक्रवर्ती इज श्रुतिज फ्रेंड, हराधन बंदोपाध्याय इज दाजू झिलमिल स्पेशल केयर होम ओनर, अरुण बाली इज झिलमिल ग्रैंड फादर, किनेथ देसाई इज सीनियर इंस्पेक्टर, राजीव मिश्रा इज इंस्पेक्टर डटर्स असिस्टेंट, प्रीति दयाल इज मिसेस दुर्जॉय चैटर्जी झिलमिल मदर, अबांटिका बिश्वास इज जिमलल सिस्टर, ओंड्रिला साहा इज जिमलल सिस्टर, सजाता सहगल इज एम्स डिसूजा झिलमिल स्पेशल केयर होम केयर टेकर, भोला राज सपकोटा इज भोला बर्फी फ्रेंड, प्रोडक्शन डेवलपमेंट आई ट्राई टू मेक द स्टोरी लिनियर बट इट वॉजंट वर्किंग सी बर्फी इज अ वेरी सिंपल स्टोरी If I had kept the narrative linear, then I'd have lost my audience. I think if I had removed the non-linear narrative, you wouldn't have enjoyed the film. I know Indian viewer get disturbed by non-linear narrations. I wrote Barfi straight, but it was boring that way. Anurag Basu, on writing the narrative, 3. During the production of his previous directorial venture Kites, 2010, director Anurag Basu wrote a two-page short story which was later developed into the script of Barfi. 4. The film script that Basu wrote alternated between two time periods, and he retained the nonlinear narrative structure. He said that the script required a 30-year time span for the character's love to grow and thus set the backdrop of the film in the 1970s. 5. In June 2010, Anurag Basu confirmed that his film would feature three lead roles, a deaf-mute man, a mentally challenged girl, and a narrator. 6. With former titles like Khamoshi or Silence, media reports said the story was grim or dark. However, Basu stated that on the contrary, the film was happy. 7. According to Basu, he paid homage to Buster Keaton and Charlie Chaplin by adding scenes inspired by the era of silent cinema and using physical comedy in the film, involving silent portions. 8. Casting. Ranbir Kapoor and Priyanka Chopra played the lead roles. Ranbir Kapoor was the first choice of director Anurag Basu and Katrina Kaif was the first choice for the role of the narrator. In March 2010, The Times of India reported that Ranbir Kapoor and Katrina Kaif were signed to play lead roles in the film, then titled Khamoshi and later Silence, which Basu confirmed. 9. Basu wanted to cast a new girl from Kolkata for the autistic character. 10. Basu's wife, Tani, suggested Chopra's name for the role. However, Basu feared that audience would see the Priyanka Chopra and not the character due to Chopra's stardom. 10. Basu explained, I had the fear that I would see Priyanka Chopra in the character and Jhilmil wouldn't work. This has happened in many films where known faces have harmed the character. 10. Priyanka Chopra was cast to play the part but, the development was not announced as Basu wanted to workshop first and see how it goes. After 3 days of workshop, Basu was convinced that Chopra could play the autistic part and reflected that he was glad that he chose Chopra for the role. 10-11, later, Basu revealed that he did not approach any actress other than Chopra for the autistic part. 5. After Chopra was cast in the film, Kaif left the project for unknown reasons. 12. Media reported that she may have opted out of the film because Chopra had been given a stronger role. 13. Later, media reported that Aseen Totamkal was approached to play the role of the narrator, replacing Kaif. 14. However, Aseen was never signed to the project. Media reported that no other actress wanted to sign for the film because, according to them, the autistic part was stronger. In July 2010, Mumbai Mirror reported that Chopra was ready to play the role of narrator and leave the autistic role, so that another actress could be cast in the film. Chopra did not want the film to stall. 15. Basu confirmed this development and said, "It's true, we've been unable to cast the other part." After facing several casting problems, Basu chose to cast a completely new fresh face to play the second female role. 16. In early December 2010, Aliana D. Cruz, a popular actress from South Indian films, was finalized for the second female lead, featuring as narrator and Kapoor's first love interest in the film, thus making her debut in Bollywood with the film. 17. Characters. Kapoor played the role of a deaf and mute man in the film. According to Kapoor, he took inspiration from screen legends such as Roberto Benigni, Charlie Chaplin and his grandfather Raj Kapoor. 18. Due to the protagonist's physical disability, Basu did not want to use any sign language but some behavioral patterns in the film. 19. Kapoor described his character as a regular, happy-go-lucky and good-hearted guy. 20. Chopra played the role of Jhilmil. Basu described Chopra's role as the toughest in the film. 10. In order to prepare for the role, Chopra visited several mental institutions and spent time with autistic people. She said she had to research a little for the role because in India awareness about autism is very low. 21. Chopra told that she had to let go of every inhibition probably that she had as a Hindi film heroine and play Jhilmil without thinking of it. She explained that she needed 2 moments to become Jhilmil because she didn't identify with her character due to difference between her thought and behavior. 22. D. Cruz, who portrayed the narrator and first love interest of the protagonist, said, "Shruti is such a sensitive role to play as she goes to different phases in the film." 23. According to Basu, after Kapoor, Chopra and D. Cruz's characters, Saurabh Shukla's character as Inspector Datta was the most important. Basu described the role as amazing character who makes others cry when he laughs. 24. Filming. Principal photography commenced in March 2011. 25. 26. Barfi was shot between June 2011 and February 2012, mostly in Darjeeling. 27. In March 2011, Basu visited Kolkata to finalize the locations within the city. Filming in Mumbai began on the 20th of March 2011 and continued until May 2011. 28. In June 2011, the cast and crew shot in Darjeeling. 29. In December 2011, some scenes were filmed on the outskirts of Coimbatore, especially Pollachi and Ooty. 30. The scenes in which Kapoor's character is chased by policemen over the rooftops were shot in Kolkata at the end of January 2012. 31. Shooting was completed by April 2012, except for some scenes featuring Chopra. The producers postponed the release from the 13th of July to the 31st of August 2012 as the September 2011 shooting schedule was cancelled and was waiting to be shot. 7.32, however, Basu began working on D. Cruz's dubbing portions by end of April 2012, because D. Cruz was unfamiliar with the Hindi language and wanted to learn it whilst filming. 33. Soundtrack. Main article, Barfi. Soundtrack. The music and background score of the film is composed by Pritam Chakraborty, and lyrics were written by Swanand Kirkire, Ashish Pandit, Nilesh Misra and Saeed Quadri. The soundtrack album has 6 original songs which released on the 9th of August 2012. The soundtrack was influenced by Brazilian Bossa Nova. 34. Priyanka Chopra was supposed to sing a track for the film, but her contract with Universal Music prevented her from taking the offer. 35. The soundtrack album also contains a song titled, Fatafati, sung by Pritam Chakraborty, Arijit Singh and Naksh Aziz, which was not be used in the film, but the song was released as a promotional single on YouTube on the 10th of September 2012 with a video which contains some behind-the-scenes footage and the additional vocals are sung by Ranbir Kapoor. The song also has some Bengali lyrics written by Amitabh Bhattacharya. 36. Marketing and release. The official trailer of the film was launched on the 2nd of July 2012 featuring all the actors. It included no dialogue, portraying comedy through gestures and actions, and was well received by critics and audiences. 37. Chopra's character was kept under wraps in the trailers as the makers were not willing to reveal much about her character to increase curiosity among the audiences and was only revealed around the release of the film. Shikha Kapoor, the executive director, marketing, of UTV, explained, Priyanka plays a very special character in Barfi, so we want to keep her mystery intact. In the first trailer, Barfi, played by Ranbir, will be unveiled. We don't plan to reveal Priyanka until the film releases. 38. Three people are smiling and looking forward. Aliana D. Cruz, Priyanka Chopra and Ranbir Kapoor at a promotional event. UTV Motion Pictures created a YouTube application called The Flavor of Barfi, designed for the marketing the film. The application features Ranbir Kapoor as his character from the film and allows users to type actions, which Kapoor acts out. The application features two zones. One asks users to change Barfi's mood and the other gives users the chance to watch him flirt. 39. The film was promoted in various cities across India. While promoting the film at the Phoenix Mall, Bangalore, the crowds broke through the barricades. 40. Barfi was released on the 14th of September 2012 on 1300 screens in 700 theatres in India. 41. Reliance Home Entertainment released Barfi on DVD and Blu-ray in mid-November 2012 across all regions in a one-disc pack complying with the NTSC format. 42. The DVD and the Blu-ray discs contained bonus content, including making of the film, Fatafati, behind the scenes, and deleted scenes. The video CD version was released at the same time. The exclusive right to broadcast the film was bought by Zee Network and UTV Movies. The deal includes premiere rights of the film along with the several other UTV productions. The rights are for a period of 7 years, consisting the premiere, for both channels, of the film. Zee Network will have multiple runs while UTV Movies will have selected runs rights. The price of the deal was not revealed by the production company. 43. The film is also available on Netflix. 44. In Japan, the film released in August 2014. It was released on 10 screens in 6 Japanese cities, Tokyo, Yokohama, Nagoya, Osaka, Kyoto and Fukuoka. 45. Controversies. On the 12th of September 2012, British manufacturer Murphy Radio claimed that its trademark Murphy Baby logo from its 1970s print advertisements has been used in Barfi without permission. 46. Producer Siddharth Roy Kapoor said that he had received a legal notice from Murphy but said that there is nothing wrong in the intention, as the brand in question has been shown in a very positive light. 47. After the film's release, several blogs and users of social media websites Twitter, Facebook and YouTube accused the director of plagiarism. 48. Media further alleged that Basu had not tried to credit the original sources. Several videos were uploaded to YouTube showing side-by-side comparisons with Hollywood films like Cops, The Adventurer, City Lights, Singin' in the Rain, Project A, The Notebook and Benny and June. They also accused Barfi's music director Pritham of copying the background music from the French film Amelie. 49. Basu defended the film by saying that he was inspired by these works and that Barfi contains an original plot, screenplay, characters and situations. 50. He said that he was paying homages to Keaton and Chaplin. 8. Barfi. S. Oscar selection for Best Foreign Language Film was criticized because of plagiarism, but Oscar selection committee chief Manju Bora defended the film by saying, Barfi deserves to be sent outside. The selection was a very open process with 3 to 4 rounds of severe discussions and came down to the best film of the final three. 51. Reception. India. A photograph of Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor and Aliana D'Cruz looking forward, smiling and posing for the camera. Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor, and Aliana D'Cruz received widespread praise for their performances in the film. Barfi received widespread critical acclaim upon release, with critics praising the cast, performances, direction, screenplay, cinematography, music and the positive portrayal of physically disabled people. 52. Zee News gave the film 5 out of 5 stars and said, all in all, Anurag Basu's Barfi is a perfect sweet treat for his audience. Like it has been discussed, those filmmakers who have been portraying the handicapped as dull and boring in their films must take a lesson from Barfi. 53. Madhurita Mukherjee of the Times of India gave the film a 4/5 rating and said, Kapoor, in the most challenging performance of his career, leaves us dumbstruck. Without use of conventional crutches of cool catchphrases, dhamakedar dialogue bazi, bare bodies, and other items, he stuns you in every single frame. For Chopra, there's only one word, bravo. In a role where she needs to under-emote, she does so brilliantly, delivering an incredible performance. 54. Roshni Devi of Koimoi said, Barfi leaves you with that warm, cuddly, magical feeling with a few tears to match. It's really worth a watch, and gave it an overall score of 3.5 stars out of 5. 55. Taran Adarsh of Bollywood Hangama gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi is akin to a whiff of fresh air. Its foremost triumph is that it leaves you with a powerful emotion, happiness. 56. Indo-Asian News Service gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi comes as close to being a modern masterpiece as cinematically possible. To miss it would be a crime. To embrace it is to serenade the sublime. 57. Anirudh Guha of Daily News and Analysis rated the film 4 out of 5 and remarked that movie engages you at a personal level, and further added that Barfi cannot be missed. It demands patience, but the payoff is incredible. 58. Pritim D. Gupta of The Telegraph said, the brilliance of Barfi is that it's no story and all storytelling. It's about a director at the top of his game orchestrating terrific talent into a bravura crescendo. Only someone who has shown that the door can open windows to life like this. 59. Filmfare gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and stated, Barfi is that rare film that can make you smile and make you cry in the same scene. Its technical brilliance is only outdone by its emotional complexity and depth. Pritham's music adds a nice silent era charm to this already fantastic story, making it an occasion when words simply aren't enough. 60. Raja Sen of Rediff.com has given 3.5 stars and wrote, Barfi is a well-crafted script with an intriguing back-and-forth narrative, but it all goes south towards the end. 61. Anupama Chopra writing for Hindustan Times gave it 3 out 5 stars and wrote, T. His is a film made with love, bolstered by wonderfully etched vignettes, Kapoor and Chopra's stupendous performances and a gorgeous soundtrack by Pritham. And yet, for me, Barfi was a singularly frustrating experience. There was so much to like, but the film never became more than the sum of its parts. 62. Rajiv Masand of CNNIBN gave 3 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi had the potential to be great cinema, But as it stands, it's a respectable film that's still better than a lot else you're likely to see. 63. On the contrary, Namrata Joshi of Outlook felt that the flashback within flashback narrative gets way too clumsy and turgid, the thriller twist absolutely pointless, appears much too crafted and self-consciously gorgeous, and feels eminently facile and plastic. 64. Overseas. The film received high critical acclaim overseas as well. On the review aggregator website Rotten Tomatoes, 86% of 14 critics' reviews are positive, with an average rating of 7.2/10. 65. Rachel Saltz of the New York Times said, "Bollywood isn't afraid to be mawkish. Barfi is at times, though not noticeably more so than most Hindi movies, despite its premise of special lovers with a special lesson to teach." 66. Lisa Sering, the Hollywood Reporter, called the film a refreshingly non-commercial exercise, and added that poignant Bollywood romantic comedy. On the performances of the cast, she wrote, "Basu has guided Kapoor, and especially Chopra, to turn in exceptionally restrained, organic performances." 67. Ronnie Sheeb of Variety wrote, "Unlike Michelle Hazanavicius' black and white silent homage, the artist, Basu's film bursts with sound and color, only the speaking and hearing impaired Basu is condemned to silence." 68. Gary Goldstein of the Los Angeles Times was more critical of the film, despite praising aspects including the hardworking cast, a lush score, exotic location shooting and scattered warmth, called it as more of an endurance test than entertainment. 69. Accolades. Mean article, list of accolades received by Barfi. Barfi has received various awards and nominations in categories ranging mostly from recognition of the film itself, to its cinematography, direction, screenplay, and music, to the cast's performances. The film was selected as India's official entry for the Best Foreign Language Film nomination for the 85th Academy Awards. 70. The film received a leading 13 nominations at the 58th Filmfare Awards, and won a leading 7 awards, including Best Film, Best Actor, Kapoor, Best Female Debut, D. Cruz, and Best Music Director, Pritham. 71. 72. Barfi received a leading 23 nominations at the 19th Screen Awards, winning 9, including Best Director, Basu, Best Actor, Kapoor, and Jodi Noh. 1. Kapoor and Chopra. 73, 74, 75, at the 14th Zee Cine Awards, Barfi received 9 nominations, and won 8 awards, including Best Film, Best Director, Basu, and Best Actress, Chopra. 76, 77. Box office. Upon its release, Barfi started strongly at multiplexes throughout India, with around 80-90% occupancy, but had lower opening takings because of a limited release. 78. The film grossed 85.6 million rupees, 1.1 million United States dollars, on its opening day. 79. Its second day saw an increase of around 35% occupancy and collected 115 million rupees, 1.4 million United States dollars. 80. In its opening weekend, the film grossed 340 million rupees, 4.3 million United States dollars. 41. In its first week, Barfi collected 565 million rupees, 7.1 million United States dollars, net, 81, and by its eighth day had earned 32.5 million rupees, 410,000 United States dollars, despite the release of Heroine. 82. Barfi earned 150 million rupees, 1.9 million United States dollars, in its second weekend. 83. Barfi had a good second week where it has collected 242 million rupees, 3 million United States dollars, net. 84. In the third week, The film's takings rose to 158 million rupees, 2 million United States dollars, net, 85, and it took 61.5 million rupees, 770,000 United States dollars, in its fourth week. 86, during its cinematic release period, Barfi earned a gross total of 1.06 billion rupees, 13 million United States dollars, in India. 87, the All India distributor share of the film was 500 million rupees, 6.3 million United States dollars. 88, the film became one of the highest grossing Bollywood films of 2012 in India, and was declared a super hit after its three-week run by Box Office India. 89, the film went on to gross 1.75 billion rupees, 22 million United States dollars, worldwide. 90, 91, internationally, Barfi earned around 124 million rupees, 1.6 million United States dollars, in its opening weekend, slightly exceeding Rajneeti, which had collected 116 million rupees, 1.5 million United States dollars, 92, by the end of its run, Barfi had grossed $6.25 million outside India, and it became one of the highest overseas grossing Bollywood films of 2012. 93. See also, list of submissions to the 85th Academy Awards for Best Foreign Language Film. List of Indian submissions for the Academy Award for Best Foreign Language Film. References. Barfi, Movie. Box Office India. Barfi, Movie. Box Office India. Barfi, Anurag Basu plans an English version. The Times of India. The 19th of September 2012. Archived. From the original on the 13th of October 2015. Retrieved the 21st of August 2014. Prabhakaran, Mahalakshmi, the 13th of September 2012. Anurag Basu's Happy State of Mind, The Reason Behind Barfi. Daily News and Analysis. Archived from the original on the 29th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Jha, Subhash K. The 18th of September 2012. Barfi is my most personal film, Anurag Basu. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 24th of September 2015. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Anurag breaks his silence. Star Box Office. The 14th of June 2010. Archived from the original on the 16th of February 2013. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Barfi not a silent film, says Anurag Basu. India Today. The 4th of July 2012. Archived from the original on the 1st of November 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi director Anurag Basu responds to plagiarism charges. CNN-IBN. The 26th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 5th of December 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Priyanka to act with Katrina. Midday. The 29th of March 2010. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2013. Retrieved the 3rd of February 2013. Barfi. Bonus disc, The Making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 13:40. Gupta, Pratim D. The 17th of September 2012. The Barfi Man. The Telegraph. Archived from the original on the 23rd of November 2012. Retrieved the 13th of April 2013. Priyanka's Powerful Silence. The Times of India. The 23rd of July 2010. Archived from the original on the 3rd of November 2012. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Katrina quits Ranbir's film. Midday. The 31st of March 2010. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2013. Retrieved the 3rd of February 2013. Jha, Subhash K. The 18th of November 2010. Asin, Priyanka in Anurag's Next. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Jha, Subhash K. The 22nd of July 2010. Priyanka breaks her silence. Mumbai Mirror. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2013. Retrieved the 3rd of February 2013. Aseen lost out role opposite Ranbir. The Times of India. The 10th of July 2010. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Jha, Subhash K. The 13th of December 2010. Anurag Basu confirms Telugu actress Aliana D'Cruz opposite Ranbir in Baafi. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 3rd of October 2012. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 10:30. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 12:20. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 9:07. Prabhakaran, Mahalakshmi, the 12th of September 2012. What is Priyanka Chopra's Kottayam connection? Daily news and analysis. Archived from the original on the 25th of October 2012. Retrieved the 15th of April 2013. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 17:35. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 19:55. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 22:15. Jha, Subhash K. The 26th of March 2011. Priyanka Chopra begins shooting for Anurag Basu's Barfi. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 1st of May 2011. Retrieved the 12th of April 2011. Jha, Subhash K. The 5th of October 2011. Release dates. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 7th of October 2011. Retrieved the 5th of October 2011. Banerjee, Amitava, the 24th of September 2012. Barfi. Emerges as Darjeeling's brand ambassador. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 21st of June 2016. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Gupta, Pratim D. The 16th of March 2011. Barfi this monsoon. The Telegraph. Archived from the original on the 29th of October 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Nag, Jayatri, the 16th of June 2011. Angry crowd brings Barfi shoot to a halt. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Ranbir Kapoor gets practical. The Times of India. The 4th of December 2011. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Check out Ranbir's daredevil act in Barfi. Bollywood Hangama. The 23rd of January 2012. Archived from the original on the 16th of July 2012. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Sugnath, M. The 23rd of January 2011. Barfi will be released worldwide on July 13th. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Priyanka Chopra delays Barfi. The Times of India. The 20th of April 2012. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Holla, Anand. On record, Yum Das Barfi. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 11th of April 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Why did Priyanka Chopra refuse to sing for Barfi? NDTV. The 7th of August 2012. Archived from the original on the 14th of September 2015. Retrieved the 7th of August 2012. Barfi Blast. Ranbir Kapoor sings for the first time. Bollywood.com. Archived from the original on the 6th of November 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Trailer releases. Ranbir trends on Twitter. Hindustan Times. Accessed via Highbeam Research. The 4th of July 2012. Archived from the original on the 25th of May 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Singh, Prashant, the 2nd of July 2012. Priyanka missing from Barfi trailer. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 9th of June 2013. Retrieved the 14th of April 2013. Barfi launches interactive app on YouTube channel. The Indian Express. The 14th of September 2012. Retrieved the 13th of April 2013. Jha, Subhash K. The 12th of September 2012. Stampede in Bangalore during Barfi. Promotions. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 21st of September 2012. Retrieved the 22nd of September 2012. Barfi has excellent weekend. Box Office India. The 17th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 19th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Ranbir Kapoor asks fans to gift Barfi DVDs this Diwali. India Today. The 12th of November 2013. Archived from the original on the 28th of January 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Unnikrishnan, Chaya, the 25th of March 2013. Barfi. Sold to Z. Daily News and Analysis. Archived from the original on the 4th of May 2013. Retrieved the 6th of April 2013. Barfi. Netflix. Retrieved the 3rd of September 2019. Barfi. Releases in Japan. The Hindu. The 22nd of August 2014. Retrieved the 17th of June 2019. Avasthi. Kavita. The 12th of September 2012. Barfi. Faces 50 crore rupees suit for copyright violation. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 9th of January 2013. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Murphy Radio shown in positive light, Barfi. Producer. Hindustan Times. The 13th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of November 2012. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. And the Oscar for the most originally plagiarized film goes to Barfi. Zee News. The 30th of September 2013. Archived from the original on the 23rd of December 2012. Retrieved the 28th of December 2012. Barfi, the thin line between inspiration and plagiarism. CNNIBN. The 27th of September 2013. Archived from the original on the 20th of November 2012. Retrieved the 28th of December 2012. Barfi. Director blasts plagiarism accusers. Hindustan Times. The 28th of September 2013. Archived from the original on the 11th of December 2012. Retrieved the 28th of December 2012. Chatterjee, Rituparna, the 28th of September 2013. We weren't paid to pick, Barfi, says Oscar Selection Committee Chief Manju Bora. CNNIBN. Archived from the original on the 6th of November 2012. Retrieved the 14th of January 2013. Barfi. Sparks debate about the portrayal of the differently abled in films. NDTV. The 22nd of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 14th of June 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Sengar. Resham, the 17th of September 2012. Barfi, review, it is an out-and-out entertainer. Zee News. Archived from the original on the 8th of February 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Mukherjee, Madhurita, the 13th of September 2012. Barfi will leave you happy high. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 15th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Review. The 13th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 30th of August 2014. Retrieved the 27th of July 2014. Adarsh, Taran, the 12th of September 2012. Barfi, Review. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 6th of February 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Indo-Asian News Service, the 14th of September 2012. Barfi. Review. NDTV. Archived from the original on the 17th of February 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Guha, Anirudh, the 14th of September 2012. Anirudh Guha Reviews, Barfi. Poetry on Celluloid. Daily News and Analysis. Archived from the original on the 14th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Gupta, Pratim D. The 15th of September 2012. Mouthful of Barfi. The Telegraph. Archived from the original on the 2nd of October 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Gupta, Ratchet, the 13th of September 2012. Movie Review. Barfi. Filmfare. Archived from the original on the 23rd of October 2012. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Sen, Raja, the 14th of September 2012. Review. Barfi. Is magical but deeply flawed. Rediff.com. Archived from the original on the 15th of September 2012. Retrieved the 14th of September 2012. Chopra. Anupama, the 15th of September 2012. Anupama Chopra's Review, Barfi. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 8th of April 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Masand, Rajiv, the 14th of September 2012. Goan, Indulge Your Sweet Tooth With, Barfi. CNNIBN. Archived from the original on the 16th of September 2012. Retrieved the 20th of September 2012. Joshi, Namrata, the 1st of October 2012. Barfi. Review. Outlook. Retrieved the 13th of April 2013. Barfi. Rotten Tomatoes. Fandango Media. Retrieved the 16th of July 2022. Edit this at Wikidata. Salts. Rachel, the 14th of September 2012. An Unconventional Romance. The New York Times. Archived from the original on the 23rd of December 2014. Retrieved the 23rd of December 2014. Tsering, Lisa, the 14th of December 2012. Barfi, Film Review. The Hollywood Reporter. Archived from the original on the 31st of January 2016. Retrieved the 20th of March 2016. Sheep, Ronnie, the 17th of September 2012. Review, Barfi. Variety. Archived from the original on the 25th of December 2014. Retrieved the 23rd of December 2014. Goldstein, Gary, the 16th of September 2012. Review, Barfi. Is just too much. Los Angeles Times. Archived from the original on the 19th of October 2015. Retrieved the 23rd of December 2014. Ranbir Kapoor's Barfi. Out of the Oscar race. Hindustan Times. The 5th of December 2012. Archived from the original on the 11th of April 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. 58th Idea Filmfare Awards nominations are here. Filmfare. The 13th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 27th of December 2014. Retrieved the 13th of January 2013. Winners of 58th Idea Filmfare Awards 2012. Bollywood Hangama. the 20th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 23rd of January 2013. Retrieved the 21st of January 2013. Nominations, 19th Annual Colors Screen Awards. Bollywood Hangama, the 2nd of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 5th of January 2013. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Winners of 19th Annual Colors Screen Awards. Bollywood Hangama, the 12th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 25th of September 2013. Retrieved the 13th of January 2013. Winners of 19th Annual Screen Awards. The Indian Express. Archived from the original on the 14th of January 2013. Retrieved the 13th of January 2013. Nominations for Zee Cine Awards 2013. Bollywood Hangama. The 29th of December 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of January 2013. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Winners of Zee Cine Awards 2013. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 27th of December 2013. Retrieved the 14th of January 2013. Barfi has strong start at multiplexes. Box Office India. The 14th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 18th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. First day territorial breakdown. Box Office India. The 15th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 17th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Has huge growth on Saturday. Box Office India. The 16th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 18th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Week 1 territorial breakdown. Box Office India. The 24th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 27th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Strong on day 8. Box Office India. The 22nd of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 25th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Has strong second weekend. Box Office India. The 24th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 27th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Week 2 territorial breakdown. Box Office India. The 1st of October 2011. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Amongst all-time highest third week figures. Box Office India. The 6th of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 8th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Week 4 territorial breakdown. Box Office India. The 16th of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 18th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Top 10 2012 Lifetime Grosses. Box Office India. The 31st of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of November 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. All India Distributor Shares 2012. Diwali Releases Combined Equal Ek Tha Tiger. Box Office India. The 30th of November 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of December 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. New releases Poor OMG. Oh my God, excellent Barfi. Closing in on 100 crore. Box Office India. The 5th of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of December 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Top 10 Worldwide Grossers 2012. Box Office India. The the 17th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 2nd of June 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Fastest to the century, Barfi. In 17 days. Box Office India. The 9th of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 11th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi does well overseas. Box Office India. The 19th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 19th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Top Grossers Overseas 2012. Box Office India. The 5th of January 2012. Archived from the original on the 8th of January 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. External links. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Barfi. Official website. Barfi. At Bollywood Hangama. Barfi. At IMDb. Edit this at Wikidata. Barfi. At Box Office Mojo. Edit this at Wikidata. VTE. Anurag Basu. Awards for Barfi. VTE. Indian Submission for Academy Award for Best International Feature Film. VTE. Films produced by UTV Motion Pictures. Portals. Flag India. Film. Icon Bollywood. Icon Comedy. Categories. 2012 Films. 2012 Romantic Comedy Drama Films. Films about autism. Films set in Darjeeling. Films set in the 1970s. Films shot in India. Films shot in Kolkata. Films shot in Mumbai. Films shot in Ooty. 2010s Hindi language films. Indian Romantic Comedy Drama Films. Indian Nonlinear Narrative Films. Films involved in plagiarism controversies. Films featuring songs by Pritam. UTV Motion Pictures Films. 2012 Comedy Films. 2012 Drama Films. Films directed by Anurag Basu. This page was last edited on the 3rd of June 2023 at 6:55 UTC. Text is available under the Creative Commons Attribution Sharealike License 3.0. Additional terms may apply. By using this site, you agree to the terms of use and privacy policy. Wikipedia is a registered trademark of the Wikimedia Foundation, Inc., a non-profit organization. Privacy Policy About Wikipedia Disclaimers Contact Wikipedia Mobile View Developer Status Text Cookie Statement Wikimedia Foundation Powered by MediaWiki. Main Menu. Wikipedia Te Free Encyclopedia. Search Wikipedia. Create Account. Login. Personal Tools. Contents Hide. Top. Plot. Toggle Plot Subsection. 1972. 1978. 2012. Cast. Production. Toggle Production Subsection. Development. Casting. Characters. Filming. Soundtrack. Marketing and Release. Toggle Marketing and Release Subsection. Controversies. Reception. Toggle Reception Subsection. India. Overseas. Accolades. Box Office. See also. References. External links. Barfi. Article. Talk. Read. Edit. View history. Tools. This is a good article. Click here for more information. From Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. This article is about the 2012 Hindi film. For the 2013 Kannada film, see Barfi film. For the South Asian suite, see Barfi. Barfi. One man and two women sit on an old wooden bench smiling at the camera, with fields of Darjeeling in the background. The title, director, producer, and distributor information is printed across the top. Text at the bottom of the poster reveals the release date and the rest of the credits. Theatrical release poster. Directed by Anurag Basu. Written by story and screenplay. Anurag Basu. Dialogues. Sanjeev Datta. Co-writer. Tani Basu. Produced by Ronnie Screwvala. Siddharth Roy Kapoor. Starring Ranbir Kapoor. Priyanka Chopra. Aliana D. Cruz. Narrated by Aliana D. Cruz. J.T. Bhatia. Saurabh Shukla. Bhola Raj Sapkota. Cinematography Ravi Vaman. Edited by Akiv Ali. Music by Pritham. Production. कंपनीज ईशाना मूवीज यूटीवी मोशन पिक्चर्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाय यूटीवी मोशन पिक्चर्स रिलीज डेट द 14th of September 2012 रनिंग टाइम 150 मिनट्स कंट्री इंडिया लैंग्वेज हिंदी बजट 35 करोड़ रुपीस 1 बॉक्स ऑफिस 175 करोड़ रुपीस 2 बर्फी is a 2012 Indian Hindi language romantic comedy drama film written and directed by Anurag Basu, edited by Akiv Ali, and produced by Ronnie Screwvala and Siddharth Roy Kapoor under the UTV Motion Pictures banner. The film stars Ranbir Kapoor as the eponymous lead with Priyanka Chopra and Aliana D'Cruz while Saurabh Shukla, Ashish Vidyarthi, Haradhan Bandopadhyay and Jishu Sengupta play supporting roles. Set in 1970s Darjeeling in Kolkata, the film is about Murphy, Burfi, Johnson, a deaf-mute young boy who develops a special bond with two young girls, while often being chased by a local police officer for his nuisances. Made on a total budget of 35 crore rupees, Burfi opened worldwide in cinemas on the 14th of September 2012. The film received critical acclaim praising the cast performances, direction, screenplay, cinematography, music and the portrayal of physically disabled people. The film turned out to be a major commercial success, becoming one of the highest-grossing Bollywood films of 2012 in India and overseas, and accumulated 175 crore rupees worldwide. Since its release, Barfi has achieved a cult status. The film was selected as India's official entry for the Best Foreign Language Film nomination for the 85th Academy Awards. Barfi won several awards and nominations at various award ceremonies across India. At the 58th Filmfare Awards, Barfi received a leading 12 nominations including Best Director, Basu, Best Actress, Chopra, and Best Supporting Actress, D'Cruz, and won a leading 7 awards including Best Film, Best Actor, Kapoor, Best Female Debut, D'Cruz, and Best Music Director, Pritham. Plot 1972. Murphy, Barfi, Johnson is a young boy who lives in Darjeeling and is known as a troublemaker as he cuts down street lampposts or plays practical jokes on innocent people and is often chased by Inspector Sudhanshu Datta. Soon, Barfi meets Shruti Ghosh, an educated young girl who is new in Darjeeling. He is smitten by her heavenly beauty and charm, thus falling in love with her. However, Shruti's mother advises her over avoiding to marry him due to his disabilities and lack of money. Shruti unwillingly agrees to her mother's advice, marries Ranjit Sengupta, and leaves Darjeeling, breaking all contact with Barfi. Shortly after Shruti's departure, Barfi's father suffers from kidney failure and is hospitalized, and Barfi is asked to arrange 7,000 rupees for his surgery. Meanwhile, Barfi's autistic childhood friend Jhilmil Chatterjee suddenly gets kidnapped and her wealthy father Durjoy Chatterjee asks Inspector Datta to search for her. After an unsuccessful attempt of robbing a local bank, Barfi finds Jhilmil in an abandoned van and drives away along with her. He hides her in his apartment and sends a 7,000 rupees ransom note to Jhilmil's family. Her father hands over the ransom to Barfi, but his father unfortunately dies just after he makes the hospital payment. A dejected Barfi leaves Jhilmil at her caretaker's house, but she refuses to stay over there and makes him take her away from there. Later, Barfi cleverly escapes from Inspector Datta along with Jhilmil and the two soon move to Kolkata. 1978. 6 years later, Barfi unexpectedly reunites with Shruti, who is unhappy with her marriage with Ranjit. She rekindles her friendship with Barfi and they begin to grow closer again, much to the jealousy of Jhilmil, who then goes missing. Shruti files a missing report of Jhilmil in the police. Soon, Inspector Datta learns about Jhilmil's disappearance, travels to Kolkata, and bumps into Barfi. After a comedic and entertaining chase, Inspector Datta manages to arrest Barfi and take him to Darjeeling. Over there, another demand of ransom is made during the process of interrogation at the police station. However, Jhilmil is apparently killed during the exchange of the ransom even though her dead body is not found. The police frame Barfi for Jhilmil's murder in order to conclude the case. Inspector Datta, who grew fond of Barfi after chasing him for his nuisances, asks Shruti to take him away, offering him a second chance in life. Shruti takes Barfi back to Kolkata, hoping that she can now finally be with him due to the loss of Jhilmil. However, Barfi discovers Jhilmil's special care home address from the scribbles that she had made at his house. He takes Shruti at the special care home where it is revealed that both the kidnappings of Jhilmil were fabricated by her father in order to embezzle much money from her trust fund. In his second attempt, he faked her death to let her live in the special care home, away from her alcoholic mother. Barfi and Jhilmil have a happy reunion over there and the two end up getting married. 2012, 34 years later, an elderly Barfi is shown to be severely ill in the hospital where Jhilmil lies with him on the hospital bed and they die together. Shruti narrates how they died peacefully, not wanting to leave each other behind in life or death. The film ends with the happy days of Barfi and Jhilmil being shown and the credits roll. Cast: Ranbir Kapoor as Murphy, Jang Bahadur Johnson aka Barfi, Priyanka Chopra as Jhilmil, Durjoy Chatterjee, Aliana D'Cruz as Shruti Ghosh, Shruti Ranjit Sengupta, Saurabh Shukla as Inspector Sudhanshu Datta, Ashish Vidyarthi as Durjoy Chatterjee, Jhilmil's father, Akash Khurana as Jang Bahadur Johnson, Barfi's father, Jishu Sengupta as Ranjit Sengupta, Shruti's fiancé turned husband, Rupa Ganguly as Mrs. Ghosh, Shruti's mother, Uday Tikekar as Mr. Ghosh, Shruti's father, Sumona Chakravarti as Shruti's friend, Haradhan Bandopadhyay as Daju, Jhilmil's special care home owner, Arun Bali as Jhilmil's grandfather, Kenneth Desai as senior inspector, Rajiv Mishra as Inspector Dutta's assistant, Preeti Dayal as Mrs. Durjoy Chatterjee, Jhilmil's mother, Abantika Bishwas as Jhilmil's sister, Oindrila Saha as Jhilmil's sister, Sajata Sehgal as M's D'Souza, Jhilmil's special care home caretaker, Bhola Raj Sapkota as Bhola, Barfi's friend. Production: Development: I tried to make the story linear, but it wasn't working. See, Barfi is a very simple story. If I had kept the narrative linear, then I'd have lost my audience. I think if I had removed the non-linear narrative, you wouldn't have enjoyed the film. I know Indian viewer get disturbed by non-linear narrations. I wrote Barfi straight, but it was boring that way. Anurag Basu, on writing the narrative, 3. During the production of his previous directorial venture Kites, 2010, director Anurag Basu wrote a 2-page short story which was later developed into the script of Barfi. 4. The film script that Basu wrote alternated between two time periods, and he retained the nonlinear narrative structure. He said that the script required a 30-year time span for the character's love to grow and thus set the backdrop of the film in the 1970s. 5. In June 2010, Anurag Basu confirmed that his film would feature 3 lead roles, a deaf-mute man, a mentally challenged girl, and a narrator. 6. With former titles like Khamoshi or Silence, media reports said the story was grim or dark. However, Basu stated that on the contrary, the film was happy. 7. According to Basu, he paid homage to Buster Keaton and Charlie Chaplin by adding scenes inspired by the era of silent cinema and using physical comedy in the film, involving silent portions. 8. Casting: Ranbir Kapoor and Priyanka Chopra played the lead roles. Ranbir Kapoor was the first choice of director Anurag Basu and Katrina Kaif was the first choice for the role of the narrator. In March 2010, The Times of India reported that Ranbir Kapoor and Katrina Kaif were signed to play lead roles in the film, then titled Khamoshi and later Silence, which Basu confirmed. 9. Basu wanted to cast a new girl from Kolkata for the autistic character. 10. Basu's wife, Tani, suggested Chopra's name for the role. However, Basu feared that audience would see the Priyanka Chopra and not the character due to Chopra's stardom. 10. Basu explained, I had the fear that I would see Priyanka Chopra in the character and Jhilmil wouldn't work. This has happened in many films where known faces have harmed the character. 10. Priyanka Chopra was cast to play the part but the development was not announced as Basu wanted to workshop first and see how it goes. After 3 days of workshop, Basu was convinced that Chopra could play the autistic part and reflected that he was glad that he chose Chopra for the role. 10-11 later, Basu revealed that he did not approach any actress other than Chopra for the autistic part. 5. After Chopra was cast in the film, Kaif left the project for unknown reasons. 12. Media reported that she may have opted out of the film because Chopra had been given a stronger role. 13. Later, media reported that Aseen Totamkal was approached to play the role of the narrator, replacing Kaif. 14. However, Aseen was never signed to the project. Media reported that no other actress wanted to sign for the film because, according to them, the autistic part was stronger. In July 2010, Mumbai Mirror reported that Chopra was ready to play the role of narrator and leave the autistic role, so that another actress could be cast in the film. Chopra did not want the film to stall. 15. Basu confirmed this development and said, it's true we've been unable to cast the other part. After facing several casting problems, Basu chose to cast a completely new fresh face to play the second female role. 16. In early December 2010, Aliana D'Cruz, a popular actress from South Indian films, was finalized for the second female lead, featuring as narrator and Kapoor's first love interest in the film, thus making her debut in Bollywood with the film. 17. Characters. Kapoor played the role of a deaf and mute man in the film. According to Kapoor, he took inspiration from screen legends such as Roberto Benigni, Charlie Chaplin and his grandfather Raj Kapoor. 18. Due to the protagonist's physical disability, Basu did not want to use any sign language but some behavioral patterns in the film. 19. Kapoor described his character as a regular, happy-go-lucky and good-hearted guy. 20. Chopra played the role of Jhilmil. Basu described Chopra's role as the toughest in the film. 10. In order to prepare for the role, Chopra visited several mental institutions and spent time with autistic people. She said she had to research a little for the role because in India awareness about autism is very low. 21. Chopra told that she had to let go of every inhibition probably that she had as a Hindi film heroine and play Jhilmil without thinking of it. She explained that she needed 2 moments to become Jhilmil because she didn't identify with her character due to difference between her thought and behavior. 22. D'Cruz, who portrayed the narrator and first love interest of the protagonist, said, Shruti is such a sensitive role to play as she goes to different phases in the film. 23. According to Basu, after Kapoor, Chopra and D'Cruz's characters, Saurabh Shukla's character as Inspector Datta was the most important. Basu described the role as amazing character who makes others cry when he laughs. 24. Filming. Principal photography commenced in March 2011. 25. 26. Barfi was shot between June 2011 and February 2012, mostly in Darjeeling. 27. In March 2011, Basu visited Kolkata to finalize the locations within the city. Filming in Mumbai began on the 20th of March 2011 and continued until May 2011. 28. In June 2011, The cast and crew shot in Darjeeling. 29. In December 2011, some scenes were filmed on the outskirts of Coimbatore, especially Pollachi and Ooty. 30. The scenes in which Kapoor's character is chased by policemen over the rooftops were shot in Kolkata at the end of January 2012. 31. Shooting was completed by April 2012, except for some scenes featuring Chopra. The producers postponed the release from the 13th of July to the 31st of August 2012 as the September 2011 shooting schedule was cancelled and was waiting to be shot. 7.32, however, Basu began working on D'Cruz's dubbing portions by end of April 2012, because D'Cruz was unfamiliar with the Hindi language and wanted to learn it whilst filming. 33. Soundtrack. Main article, Barfi. Soundtrack. The music and background score of the film is composed by Pritham Chakraborty, and lyrics were written by Swanand Kirkire, Ashish Pandit, Nilesh Misra and Saeed Quadri. The soundtrack album has 6 original songs which released on the 9th of August 2012. The soundtrack was influenced by Brazilian bossa nova. 34. Priyanka Chopra was supposed to sing a track for the film, but her contract with Universal Music prevented her from taking the offer. 35. The soundtrack album also contains a song titled, Fatafati, sung by Pritham Chakraborty, Arijit Singh and Naksh Aziz, which was not be used in the film, but the song was released as a promotional single on YouTube on the 10th of September 2012 with a video which contains some behind-the-scenes footage and the additional vocals are sung by Ranbir Kapoor. The song also has some Bengali lyrics written by Amitabh Bhattacharya. 36. Marketing and release. The official trailer of the film was launched on the 2nd of July 2012 featuring all the actors. It included no dialogue, portraying comedy through gestures and actions, and was well received by critics and audiences. 37. Chopra's character was kept under wraps in the trailers as the makers were not willing to reveal much about her character to increase curiosity among the audiences and was only revealed around the release of the film. Shikha Kapoor, the executive director, marketing, of UTV, explained, Priyanka plays a very special character in Barfi, so we want to keep her mystery intact. In the first trailer, Barfi, played by Ranbir, will be unveiled. We don't plan to reveal Priyanka until the film releases. 38. Three people are smiling and looking forward. Aliana D'Cruz, Priyanka Chopra and Ranbir Kapoor at a promotional event. UTV Motion Pictures created a YouTube application called The Flavor of Barfi, designed for the marketing the film. The application features Ranbir Kapoor as his character from the film and allows users to type actions, which Kapoor acts out. The application features 2 zones, one asks users to change Barfi's mood and the other gives users the chance to watch him flirt. 39. The film was promoted in various cities across India. While promoting the film at the Phoenix Mall, Bangalore, the crowds broke through the barricades. 40. Barfi was released on the 14th of September 2012 on 1300 screens in 700 theatres in India. 41. Reliance Home Entertainment released Barfi on DVD and Blu-ray in mid-November 2012 across all regions in a one-disc pack complying with the NTSC format. 42. The DVD and the Blu-ray discs contained bonus content, including making of the film, Fatafati, behind the scenes, and deleted scenes. The video CD version was released at the same time. The exclusive right to broadcast the film was bought by Zee Network and UTV Movies. The deal includes premiere rights of the film along with the several other UTV productions. The rights are for a period of 7 years, consisting the premiere, for both channels, of the film. Zee Network will have multiple runs while UTV Movies will have selected runs rights. The price of the deal was not revealed by the production company. 43. The film is also available on Netflix. 44. In Japan, the film released in August 2014. It was released on 10 screens in 6 Japanese cities, Tokyo, Yokohama, Nagoya, Osaka, Kyoto and Fukuoka. 45. Controversies. On the 12th of September 2012, British manufacturer Murphy Radio claimed that its trademark Murphy Baby logo from its 1970s print advertisements has been used in Barfi without permission. 46. Producer Siddharth Roy Kapoor said that he had received a legal notice from Murphy but said that there is nothing wrong in the intention, as the brand in question has been shown in a very positive light. 47. After the film's release, several blogs and users of social media websites Twitter, Facebook and YouTube accused the director of plagiarism. 48. Media further alleged that Basu had not tried to credit the original sources. Several videos were uploaded to YouTube showing side-by-side comparisons with Hollywood films like Cops, The Adventurer, City Lights, Singin' in the Rain, Project A, The Notebook and Benny and June. They also accused Barfi's music director Pritham of copying the background music from the French film Amelie. 49. Basu defended the film by saying that he was inspired by these works and that Barfi contains an original plot, screenplay, characters and situations. 50. He said that he was paying homages to Keaton and Chaplin. 8. Barfi's Oscar selection for Best Foreign Language Film was criticized because of plagiarism, but Oscar selection committee chief Manju Bora defended the film by saying, Barfi deserves to be sent outside. The selection was a very open process with 3 to 4 rounds of severe discussions and came down to the best film of the final three. 51. Reception. India. A photograph of Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor and Aliana D'Cruz looking forward, smiling and posing for the camera. Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor, and Aliana D'Cruz received widespread praise for their performances in the film. Barfi received widespread critical acclaim upon release, with critics praising the cast, performances, direction, screenplay, cinematography, music and the positive portrayal of physically disabled people. 52. Zee News gave the film 5 out of 5 stars and said, all in all, Anurag Basu's Barfi is a perfect sweet treat for his audience. Like it has been discussed, those filmmakers who have been portraying the handicapped as dull and boring in their films must take a lesson from Barfi. 53. Madhurita Mukherjee of the Times of India gave the film a 4/5 rating and said, Kapoor, in the most challenging performance of his career, leaves us dumbstruck. Without use of conventional crutches of cool catchphrases, dhamakedar dialogue bazi, bare bodies, and other items, he stuns you in every single frame. For Chopra, there's only one word, bravo. In a role where she needs to under-emote, she does so brilliantly, delivering an incredible performance. 54. Roshni Devi of Koimoi said, Barfi leaves you with that warm, cuddly, magical feeling with a few tears to match. It's really worth a watch, and gave it an overall score of 3.5 stars out of 5. 55. Tarun Adarsh of Bollywood Hangama gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi is akin to a whiff of fresh air. Its foremost triumph is that it leaves you with a powerful emotion, happiness. 56. Indo-Asian News Service gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi comes as close to being a modern masterpiece as cinematically possible. To miss it would be a crime. To embrace it is to serenade the sublime. 57. Anirudh Guha of Daily News and Analysis rated the film 4 out of 5 and remarked that movie engages you at a personal level, and further added that Barfi cannot be missed. It demands patience, but the payoff is incredible. 58. Pritim D. Gupta of The Telegraph said, The brilliance of Barfi is that it's no story and all storytelling. It's about a director at the top of his game orchestrating terrific talent into a bravura crescendo. Only someone who has showed death the door can open windows to life like this. 59. Filmfare gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and stated, Barfi is that rare film that can make you smile and make you cry in the same scene. Its technical brilliance is only outdone by its emotional complexity and depth. Pritham's music adds a nice silent era charm to this already fantastic story, making it an occasion when words simply aren't enough. 60. Raja Sen of Rediff.com has given 3.5 stars and wrote, Barfi is a well-crafted script with an intriguing back-and-forth narrative, but it all goes south towards the end. 61. Anupama Chopra, writing for Hindustan Times, gave it 3 out 5 stars and wrote, T. His is a film made with love, bolstered by wonderfully etched vignettes, Kapoor and Chopra's stupendous performances and a gorgeous soundtrack by Pritham. And yet, for me, Barfi was a singularly frustrating experience. There was so much to like, but the film never became more than the sum of its parts. 62. Rajiv Masand of CNNIBN gave 3 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi had the potential to be great cinema, but as it stands, it's a respectable film that's still better than a lot else you're likely to see. 63. On the contrary, Namrata Joshi of Outlook felt that the flashback within flashback narrative gets way too clumsy and turgid, the thriller twist absolutely pointless, appears much too crafted and self-consciously gorgeous, and feels eminently facile and plastic. 64. Overseas. The film received high critical acclaim overseas as well. On the review aggregator website Rotten Tomatoes, 86% of 14 critics' reviews are positive, with an average rating of 7.2/10. 65. Rachel Saltz of The New York Times said, Bollywood isn't afraid to be mawkish. Barfi is at times, though not noticeably more so than most Hindi movies, despite its premise of special lovers with a special lesson to teach. 66. Lisa Sering, The Hollywood Reporter, called the film a refreshingly non-commercial exercise, and added that poignant Bollywood romantic comedy. On the performances of the cast, she wrote, Basu has guided Kapoor, and especially Chopra, to turn in exceptionally restrained, organic performances. 67. Ronnie Sheeb of Variety wrote, unlike Michel Hazanavicius' black and white silent homage, the artist, Basu's film bursts with sound and color, only the speaking and hearing impaired Basu is condemned to silence. 68. Gary Goldstein of the Los Angeles Times was more critical of the film, despite praising aspects including the hardworking cast, a lush score, exotic location shooting and scattered warmth, called it as more of an endurance test than entertainment. 69. Accolades. Mean article, list of accolades received by Barfi. Barfi has received various awards and nominations in categories ranging mostly from recognition of the film itself, to its cinematography, direction, screenplay, and music, to the cast's performances. The film was selected as India's official entry for the Best Foreign Language Film nomination for the 85th Academy Awards. 70. The film received a leading 13 nominations at the 58th Filmfare Awards, and won a leading 7 awards, including Best Film, Best Actor, Kapoor, Best Female Debut, D. Cruz, and Best Music Director, Pritham. 71. 72. Barfi received a leading 23 nominations at the 19th Screen Awards, winning 9, including Best Director, Basu, Best Actor, Kapoor, and Jodi No. 1. Kapoor and Chopra. 73, 74, 75, at the 14th Zee Cine Awards, Barfi received 9 nominations, and won 8 awards, including Best Film, Best Director, Basu, and Best Actress, Chopra. 76-77. Box office. Upon its release, Barfi started strongly at multiplexes throughout India, with around 80-90% occupancy, but had lower opening takings because of a limited release. 78, the film grossed 85.6 million rupees, 1.1 million United States dollars, on its opening day. 79, its second day saw an increase of around 35% occupancy and collected 115 million rupees, 1.4 million United States dollars. 80, in its opening weekend, the film grossed 340 million rupees, 4.3 million United States dollars. 41, in its first week, Barfi collected 565 million rupees, 7.1 million United States dollars, net, 81, and by its eighth day had earned 32.5 million rupees, 410,000 United States dollars, despite the release of Heroine. 82, Barfi earned 150 million rupees, 1.9 million United States dollars, in its second weekend. 83, Barfi had a good second week where it has collected 242 million rupees, 3 million United States dollars, net. 84, in the third week, the film's takings rose to 158 million rupees, 2 million United States dollars, net, 85, and it took 61.5 million rupees, 770,000 United States dollars, in its fourth week. 86, during its cinematic release period, Barfi earned a gross total of 1.06 billion rupees, 13 million United States dollars, in India. 87, the All India distributor share of the film was 500 million rupees, 6.3 million United States dollars. 88, the film became one of the highest grossing Bollywood films of 2012 in India, and was declared a super hit after its three-week run by Box Office India. 89, the film went on to gross 1.75 billion rupees, 22 million United States dollars, worldwide. 90-91, internationally, Barfi earned around 124 million rupees, 1.6 million United States dollars, in its opening weekend, slightly exceeding Rajneeti, which had collected 116 million rupees, 1.5 million United States dollars, 92, by the end of its run, Barfi had grossed $6.25 million outside India, and it became one of the highest overseas grossing Bollywood films of 2012. 93. See also, list of submissions to the 85th Academy Awards for Best Foreign Language Film. List of Indian submissions for the Academy Award for Best Foreign Language Film. References. Barfi, Movie. Box Office India. Barfi, Movie. Box Office India. Barfi, Anurag Basu plans an English version. The Times of India. The 19th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 13th of October 2015. Retrieved the 21st of August 2014. Prabhakaran, Mahalakshmi, the 13th of September 2012. Anurag Basu's Happy State of Mind: The Reason Behind Barfi. Daily News and Analysis. Archived from the original on the 29th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Jha, Subhash K. The 18th of September 2012. Barfi is my most personal film. Anurag Basu. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 24th of September 2015. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Anurag breaks his silence. Star Box Office. The 14th of June 2010. Archived from the original on the 16th of February 2013. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Barfi not a silent film, says Anurag Basu. India Today. The 4th of July 2012. Archived from the original on the 1st of November 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi director Anurag Basu responds to plagiarism charges. CNN-IBN. The 26th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 5th of December 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Priyanka to act with Katrina. Midday. The 29th of March 2010. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2013. Retrieved the 3rd of February 2013. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 13:40. Gupta. Pratim D. The 17th of September 2012. The Barfi. Man. The Telegraph. Archived from the original on the 23rd of November 2012. Retrieved the 13th of April 2013. Priyanka's Powerful, Silence. The Times of India. The 23rd of July 2010. Archived from the original on the 3rd of November 2012. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Katrina quits Ranbir's film. Midday. The 31st of March 2010. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2013. Retrieved the 3rd of February 2013. Cha, Subhash K. The 18th of November 2010. Aseen, Priyanka in Anurag's Next. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Cha, Subhash K. The 22nd of July 2010. Priyanka breaks her silence. Mumbai Mirror. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2013. Retrieved the 3rd of February 2013. Aseen lost out role opposite Ranbir. The Times of India. The 10th of July 2010. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Cha, Subhash K. The 13th of December 2010. Anurag Basu confirms Telugu actress Aliana D'Cruz opposite Ranbir in Barfi. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 3rd of October 2012. Retrieved the 9th of January 2013. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 10:30. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 12:20. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 9:07. Prabhakaran, Mahalakshmi, the 12th of September 2012. What is Priyanka Chopra's Kottayam connection? Daily news and analysis. Archived from the original on the 25th of October 2012. Retrieved the 15th of April 2013. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 17:35. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 19:55. Barfi. Bonus disc. The making of Barfi. Event occurs at approximately 22:15. Cha, Subhash K. The 26th of March 2011. Priyanka Chopra begins shooting for Anurag Basu's Barfi. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 1st of May 2011. Retrieved the 12th of April 2011. Cha, Subhash K. The 5th of October 2011. Release dates. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 7th of October 2011. Retrieved the 5th of October 2011. Banerjee, Amitava, the 24th of September 2012. Barfi. Emerges as Darjeeling's brand ambassador. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 21st of June 2016. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Gupta. Pratim D. The 16th of March 2011. Barfi this monsoon. The Telegraph. Archived from the original on the 29th of October 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Nag, Jayatri, the 16th of June 2011. Angry crowd brings Barfi shoot to a halt. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Ranbir Kapoor gets practical. The Times of India. The 4th of December 2011. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Check out Ranbir's daredevil act in Barfi. Bollywood Hangama. The 23rd of January 2012. Archived from the original on the 16th of July 2012. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Sugnath, M. The 23rd of January 2011. Barfi will be released worldwide on July 13th. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Priyanka Chopra delays Barfi. The Times of India. The 20th of April 2012. Archived from the original on the 3rd of June 2013. Retrieved the 30th of December 2012. Holla, Anand. On record, Yamdas Barfi. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 11th of April 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Why did Priyanka Chopra refuse to sing for Barfi? NDTV. The 7th of August 2012. Archived from the original on the 14th of September 2015. Retrieved the 7th of August 2012. Barfi Blast. Ranbir Kapoor sings for the first time. Bollywood.com. Archived from the original on the 6th of November 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi. Trailer releases. Ranbir trends on Twitter. Hindustan Times. Accessed via Highbeam Research. The 4th of July 2012. Archived from the original on the 25th of May 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Singh. Prashant. The 2nd of July 2012. Priyanka missing from Barfi trailer. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 9th of June 2013. Retrieved the 14th of April 2013. Barfi. Launches interactive app on YouTube channel. The Indian Express. The 14th of September 2012. Retrieved the 13th of April 2013. Cha. Subhash K. The 12th of September 2012. Stampede in Bangalore during Barfi. Promotions. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 21st of September 2012. Retrieved the 22nd of September 2012. Barfi. Has excellent weekend. Box Office India. The 17th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 19th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Ranbir Kapoor asks fans to gift Barfi DVDs this Diwali. India Today. The 12th of November 2013. Archived from the original on the 28th of January 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Unnikrishnan, Chaya. The 25th of March 2013. Barfi. Sold to Z. Daily News and Analysis. Archived from the original on the 4th of May 2013. Retrieved the 6th of April 2013. Barfi. Netflix. Retrieved the 3rd of September 2019. Barfi. Releases in Japan. The Hindu. The 22nd of August 2014. Retrieved the 17th of June 2019. Avasthi. Kavita. The 12th of September 2012. Barfi. Faces 50 crore rupees suit for copyright violation. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 9th of January 2013. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Murphy Radio shown in positive light, Barfi. Producer. Hindustan Times. The 13th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of November 2012. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. And the Oscar for the most originally plagiarized film goes to Barfi. Zee News. The 30th of September 2013. Archived from the original on the 23rd of December 2012. Retrieved the 28th of December 2012. Burfi, The Thin Line Between Inspiration and Plagiarism. CNNIBN. The 27th of September 2013. Archived from the original on the 20th of November 2012. Retrieved the 28th of December 2012. Burfi. Director blasts plagiarism accusers. Hindustan Times. The 28th of September 2013. Archived from the original on the 11th of December 2012. Retrieved the 28th of December 2012. Chatterjee, Rituparna. The 28th of September 2013. We weren't paid to pick, Burfi, says Oscar Selection Committee Chief Manju Bora. CNNIBN. Archived from the original on the 6th of November 2012. Retrieved the 14th of January 2013. Burfi. Sparks debate about the portrayal of the differently abled in films. NDTV. The 22nd of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 14th of June 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Sengar, Resham, the 17th of September 2012. Burfi, Review, It is an out-and-out entertainer. Zee News. Archived from the original on the 8th of February 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Mukherjee, Madhurita, the 13th of September 2012. Burfi will leave you, happy high. The Times of India. Archived from the original on the 15th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi. Review. The 13th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 30th of August 2014. Retrieved the 27th of July 2014. Adarsh, Taran, the 12th of September 2012. Burfi, Review. Bollywood Hangama. Archived from the original on the 6th of February 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Indo-Asian News Service, the 14th of September 2012. Burfi, Review. NDTV. Archived from the original on the 17th of February 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Guha. Anirudh, the 14th of September 2012. Anirudh Guha Reviews, Burfi. Poetry on Celluloid. Daily News and Analysis. Archived from the original on the 14th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Gupta, Pratim D. The 15th of September 2012. Mouthful of Burfi. The Telegraph. Archived from the original on the 2nd of October 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Gupta, Rachit, the 13th of September 2012. Movie Review, Burfi. Filmfare. Archived from the original on the 23rd of October 2012. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Sen, Raja, the 14th of September 2012. Review, Burfi. Is magical but deeply flawed. Rediff.com. Archived from the original on the 15th of September 2012. Retrieved the 14th of September 2012. Chopra, Anupama, the 15th of September 2012. Anupama Chopra's Review, Burfi. Hindustan Times. Archived from the original on the 8th of April 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Massand, Rajiv, the 14th of September 2012. Go on, indulge your sweet tooth with, Burfi. CNNIBN. Archived from the original on the 16th of September 2012. Retrieved the 20th of September 2012. Joshi, Namrata, the 1st of October 2012. Burfi. Review. Outlook. Retrieved the 13th of April 2013. Burfi. Rotten Tomatoes. Fandango Media. Retrieved the 16th of July 2022. Edit this at Wikidata. Salts, Rachel, the 14th of September 2012. An Unconventional Romance. The New York Times. Archived from the original on the 23rd of December 2014. retrieved the 23rd of December 2014. Tsering, Lisa, the 14th of December 2012. Burfi, film review. The Hollywood Reporter, archived from the original on the 31st of January 2016. Retrieved the 20th of March 2016. Sheeb, Ronnie, the 17th of September 2012. Review, Burfi, Variety, archived from the original on the 25th of December 2014. Retrieved the 23rd of December 2014. Goldstein, Gary, the 16th of September 2012. Review, Burfi, is just too much. Los Angeles Times, archived from the original on the 19th of October 2015. Retrieved the 23rd of December 2014. Ranbir Kapoor's Burfi, out of the Oscar race. Hindustan Times, the 5th of December 2012. Archived from the original on the 11th of April 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. 58th IDEA Filmfare Awards nominations are here. Filmfare, the 13th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 27th of December 2014. Retrieved the 13th of January 2013. Winners of 58th IDEA Filmfare Awards 2012. Bollywood Hangama, the 20th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 23rd of January 2013. Retrieved the 21st of January 2013. Nominations, 19th Annual Colors Screen Awards. Bollywood Hangama, the 2nd of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 5th of January 2013. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Winners of 19th Annual Colors Screen Awards. Bollywood Hangama, the 12th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 25th of September 2013. Retrieved the 13th of January 2013. Winners of 19th Annual Screen Awards. The Indian Express, archived from the original on the 14th of January 2013. Retrieved the 13th of January 2013. Nominations for Zee Cine Awards 2013. Bollywood Hangama, the 29th of December 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of January 2013. Retrieved the 4th of January 2013. Winners of Zee Cine Awards 2013. Bollywood Hangama, archived from the original on the 27th of December 2013. Retrieved the 14th of January 2013. Burfi has strong start at multiplexes. Box Office India, the 14th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 18th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi, first day territorial breakdown. Box Office India, the 15th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 17th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi has huge growth on Saturday. Box Office India, the 16th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 18th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi, week 1 territorial breakdown. Box Office India, the 24th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 27th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi, strong on day 8. Box Office India, the 22nd of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 25th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi has strong second weekend. Box Office India, the 24th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 27th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Burfi, week 2 territorial breakdown. Box Office India, the 1st of October 2011. Archived from the original on the 4th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. बर्फी अमंगस्ट ऑल टाइम हाईएस्ट थर्ड वीक फिगर्स। बॉक्स ऑफिस इंडिया द 6th of October 2012 अकाइव्ड फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल ऑन द 8th of October 2012 रिट्रीव्ड द 11th of April 2013 बर्फी वीक 4 टेरिटोरियल ब्रेकडाउन। बॉक्स ऑफिस इंडिया द 16th of October 2012 Archived from the original on the 18th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Top 10 2012 Lifetime Grosses. Box Office India. The 31st of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of November 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. All India Distributor Shares 2012. Diwali releases combined equal Ek Tha Tiger. Box Office India. The 30th of November 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of December 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. New releases Poor OMG. Oh My God Excellent Barfi. Closing in on 100 crore. Box Office India. The 5th of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 2nd of December 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Top 10 Worldwide Grossers 2012. Box Office India. The 17th of January 2013. Archived from the original on the 2nd of June 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Fastest to the Century, Barfi. In 17 days. Box Office India. The 9th of October 2012. Archived from the original on the 11th of October 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Barfi does well overseas. Box Office India. The 19th of September 2012. Archived from the original on the 19th of September 2012. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. Top Grosses Overseas 2012. Box Office India. The 5th of January 2012. Archived from the original on the 8th of January 2013. Retrieved the 11th of April 2013. External links. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Barfi. Official website. Barfi. At Bollywood Hangama. Barfi. At IMDb. Edit this at Wikidata. Barfi. At Box Office Mojo. Edit this at Wikidata. VTE. Anurag Basu. Awards for Barfi. VTE. Indian Submission for Academy Award for Best International Feature Film. VTE. Films produced by UTV Motion Pictures. Portals. Flag India. Film. Icon Bollywood. Icon Comedy. Categories. 2012 Films 2012 Romantic Comedy Drama Films Films About Autism Films Set in Darjeeling Films Set in the 1970s Films Shot in India Films Shot in Kolkata Films Shot in Mumbai Films Shot in Ooty 2010s Hindi Language Films Indian Romantic Comedy Drama Films Indian Nonlinear Narrative Films Films Involved in Plagiarism Controversies Films Featuring Songs by Pritamu TV Motion Pictures Films 2012 Comedy Films 2012 Drama Films Films directed by Anurag Basu. This page was last edited on the 3rd of June 2023 at 6:55 UTC. Text is available under the Creative Commons Attribution Share-like license 3.0. Additional terms may apply. By using this site, you agree to the terms of use and privacy policy. Wikipedia is a registered trademark of the Wikimedia Foundation, Inc., a non-profit organization. Privacy policy about Wikipedia disclaimers contact Wikipedia mobile view developers status text cookie statement Wikimedia Foundation powered by MediaWiki. Main menu. Wikipedia te free encyclopedia. Search Wikipedia. Create account. Login. Personal tools. Contents hide. Top. Plot. Toggle plot subsection. 1972. 1978. 2012. Cast. Production. Toggle production subsection. Development. Casting. Characters. Filming. Soundtrack. Marketing and release. Toggle marketing and release subsection. Controversies. Reception. Toggle Reception Subsection India Overseas Accolades Box Office See also References External links Barfi Article Talk Read Edit View History Tools This is a good article. Click here for more information. From Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. This article is about the 2012 Hindi film. For the 2013 Kannada film, see Barfi film. For the South Asian sweet, see Barfi. Barfi. One man and two women sit on an old wooden bench smiling at the camera, with fields of Darjeeling in the background. The title, director, producer, and distributor information is printed across the top. Text at the bottom of the poster reveals the release date and the rest of the credits. Theatrical release poster. Directed by Anurag Basu. Written by story and screenplay. Anurag Basu. Dialogues. Sanjeev Datta. Co-writer. Tani Basu. Produced by Ronnie Screwvala. Siddharth Roy Kapoor. Starring Ranbir Kapoor. Priyanka Chopra. Aliana D. Cruz. Narrated by. Aliana D. Cruz. J.T. Bhatia. Saurabh Shukla. Bhola Raj Sapkota. Cinematography Ravi Vaman. Edited by Akiv Ali. Music by Pritham. Production. Companies. Ishana Movies. UTV Motion Pictures. Distributed by UTV Motion Pictures. Release date. The 14th of September 2012. Running time 150 minutes. Country India. Language Hindi. Budget 35 crore rupees, 1. Box office 175 crore rupees, 2. Barfi. Is a 2012 Indian Hindi language romantic comedy drama film written and directed by Anurag Basu, edited by Akiv Ali, and produced by Ronnie Screwvala and Siddharth Roy Kapoor under the UTV Motion Pictures banner. The film stars Ranbir Kapoor as the eponymous lead with Priyanka Chopra and Aliana D. Cruz while Saurabh Shukla, Ashish Vidyarthi, Haradhan Bandopadhyay and Jishu Sengupta play supporting roles. Set in 1970s Darjeeling in Kolkata, the film is about Murphy, Barfi, Johnson, a deaf-mute young boy who develops a special bond with two young girls, while often being chased by a local police officer for his nuisances. Made on a total budget of 35 crore rupees, Barfi opened worldwide in cinemas on the 14th of September 2012. The film received critical acclaim praising the cast performances, direction, screenplay, cinematography, music and the portrayal of physically disabled people. The film turned out to be a major commercial success, becoming one of the highest-grossing Bollywood films of 2012 in India and overseas, and accumulated 175 crore rupees worldwide. Since its release, Barfi has achieved a cult status. The film was selected as India's official entry for the Best Foreign Language Film nomination for the 85th Academy Awards. Barfi won several awards and nominations at various award ceremonies across India. At the 58th Filmfare Awards, Barfi received a leading 12 nominations including Best Director, Basu, Best Actress, Chopra, and Best Supporting Actress, D. Cruz, and won a leading 7 awards including Best Film, Best Actor, Kapoor, Best Female Debut, D. Cruz, and Best Music Director, Pritham. Plot. 1972. Murphy, Barfi, Johnson is a young boy who lives in Darjeeling and is known as a troublemaker as he cuts down street lampposts or plays practical jokes on innocent people and is often chased by Inspector Sudhanshu Datta. Soon, Barfi meets Shruti Ghosh, an educated young girl who is new in Darjeeling. He is smitten by her heavenly beauty and charm, thus falling in love with her. However, Shruti's mother advises her over avoiding to marry him due to his disabilities and lack of money. Shruti unwillingly agrees to her mother's advice, marries Ranjit Sengupta, and leaves Darjeeling, breaking all contact with Barfi. Shortly after Shruti's departure, Barfi's father suffers from kidney failure and is hospitalized, and Barfi is asked to arrange 7,000 rupees for his surgery. Meanwhile, Barfi's autistic childhood friend Jhilmil Chatterjee suddenly gets kidnapped and her wealthy father Durjoy Chatterjee asks Inspector Datta to search for her. After an unsuccessful attempt of robbing a local bank, Barfi finds Jhilmil in an abandoned van and drives away along with her. He hides her in his apartment and sends a 7,000 rupees ransom note to Jhilmil's family. Her father hands over the ransom to Barfi, but his father unfortunately dies just after he makes the hospital payment. A dejected Barfi leaves Jhilmil at her caretaker's house, but she refuses to stay over there and makes him take her away from there. Later, Barfi cleverly escapes from Inspector Datta along with Jhilmil and the two soon move to Kolkata. 1978. 6 years later, Barfi unexpectedly reunites with Shruti, who is unhappy with her marriage with Ranjit. She rekindles her friendship with Barfi and they begin to grow closer again, much to the jealousy of Jhilmil, who then goes missing. Shruti files a missing report of Jhilmil in the police. Soon, Inspector Datta learns about Jhilmil's disappearance, travels to Kolkata, and bumps into Barfi. After a comedic and entertaining chase, Inspector Datta manages to arrest Barfi and take him to Darjeeling. Over there, another demand of ransom is made during the process of interrogation at the police station. However, Jhilmil is apparently killed during the exchange of the ransom, even though her dead body is not found. The police frame Barfi for Jhilmil's murder in order to conclude the case. Inspector Datta, who grew fond of Barfi after chasing him for his nuisances, asks Shruti to take him away, offering him a second chance in life. Shruti takes Barfi back to Kolkata, hoping that she can now finally be with him due to the loss of Jhilmil. However, Barfi discovers Jhilmil's special care home address from the scribbles that she had made at his house. He takes Shruti at the special care home, where it is revealed that both the kidnappings of Jhilmil were fabricated by her father in order to embezzle much money from her trust fund. In his second attempt, he faked her death to let her live in the special care home, away from her alcoholic mother. Barfi and Jhilmil have a happy reunion over there and the two end up getting married. 2012. 34 years later, an elderly Barfi is shown to be severely ill in the hospital, where Jhilmil lies with him on the hospital bed and they die together. Shruti narrates how they died peacefully, not wanting to leave each other behind in life or death. The film ends with the happy days of Barfi and Jhilmil being shown and the credits roll. Cast: Ranbir Kapoor as Murphy, Jangbahadur Johnson aka Barfi, Priyanka Chopra as Jhilmil Durjoy Chatterjee, Aliana D'Cruz as Shruti Ghosh, Shruti Ranjit Sengupta, Saurabh Shukla as Inspector Sudhanshu Datta, Ashish Vidyarthi as Durjoy Chatterjee, Jhilmil's father, Akash Khurana as Jangbahadur Johnson, Barfi's father, Jishu Sengupta as Ranjit Sengupta, Shruti's fiancé turned husband, Rupa Ganguly as Mrs. Ghosh, Shruti's mother, Uday Tikekar as Mr. Ghosh, Shruti's father, Sumona Chakravarti as Shruti's friend, Haradhan Bandopadhyay as Daju, Jhilmil's special care home owner, Arun Bali as Jhilmil's grandfather, Kenneth Desai as senior inspector, Rajiv Mishra as Inspector Dutta's assistant, Preeti Dayal as Mrs. Durjoy Chatterjee, Jhilmil's mother, Abantika Bishwas as Jhilmil's sister, Oindrila Saha as Jhilmil's sister, Sajata Sehgal as M's D'Souza, Jhilmil's special care home caretaker, Bhola Raj Sapkota as Bhola, Barfi's friend. Production: Development: I tried to make the story linear, but it wasn't working. See, Barfi is a very simple story. If I had kept the narrative linear, then I'd have lost my audience. I think if I had removed the non-linear narrative, you wouldn't have enjoyed the film. I know Indian viewer get disturbed by non-linear narrations. I wrote Barfi straight, but it was boring that way. Anurag Basu on writing the narrative. 3. During the production of his previous directorial venture Kites, 2010, director Anurag Basu wrote a 2-page short story which was later developed into the script of Barfi. 4. The film script that Basu wrote alternated between two time periods, and he retained the nonlinear narrative structure. He said that the script required a 30-year time span for the character's love to grow and thus set the backdrop of the film in the 1970s. 5. In June 2010, Anurag Basu confirmed that his film would feature 3 lead roles, a deaf-mute man, a mentally challenged girl, and a narrator. 6. With former titles like Khamoshi or Silence, media reports said the story was grim or dark. However, Basu stated that on the contrary, the film was happy. 7. According to Basu, he paid homage to Buster Keaton and Charlie Chaplin by adding scenes inspired by the era of silent cinema and using physical comedy in the film, involving silent portions. 8. Casting. Ranbir Kapoor and Priyanka Chopra played the lead roles. Ranbir Kapoor was the first choice of director Anurag Basu and Katrina Kaif was the first choice for the role of the narrator. In March 2010, The Times of India reported that Ranbir Kapoor and Katrina Kaif were signed to play lead roles in the film, then titled Khamoshi and later Silence, which Basu confirmed. 9. Basu wanted to cast a new girl from Kolkata for the autistic character. 10. Basu's wife, Tani, suggested Chopra's name for the role. However, Basu feared that audience would see the Priyanka Chopra and not the character due to Chopra's stardom. 10. Basu explained, I had the fear that I would see Priyanka Chopra in the character and Jhilmil wouldn't work. This has happened in many films where known faces have harmed the character. 10. Priyanka Chopra was cast to play the part but the development was not announced as Basu wanted to workshop first and see how it goes. After 3 days of workshop, Basu was convinced that Chopra could play the autistic part and reflected that he was glad that he chose Chopra for the role. 10-11 later, Basu revealed that he did not approach any actress other than Chopra for the autistic part. 5. After Chopra was cast in the film, Kaif left the project for unknown reasons. 12. Media reported that she may have opted out of the film because Chopra had been given a stronger role. 13. Later, media reported that Aseen Totamkal was approached to play the role of the narrator, replacing Kaif. 14. However, Aseen was never signed to the project. Media reported that no other actress wanted to sign for the film because, according to them, the autistic part was stronger. In July 2010, Mumbai Mirror reported that Chopra was ready to play the role of narrator and leave the autistic role, so that another actress could be cast in the film. Chopra did not want the film to stall. 15. Basu confirmed this development and said, it's true we've been unable to cast the other part. After facing several casting problems, Basu chose to cast a completely new fresh face to play the second female role. 16. In early December 2010, Aliana D'Cruz, a popular actress from South Indian films, was finalized for the second female lead, featuring as narrator and Kapoor's first love interest in the film, thus making her debut in Bollywood with the film. 17. Characters. Kapoor played the role of a deaf and mute man in the film. According to Kapoor, he took inspiration from screen legends such as Roberto Benigni, Charlie Chaplin and his grandfather Raj Kapoor. 18. Due to the protagonist's physical disability, Basu did not want to use any sign language but some behavioral patterns in the film. 19. Kapoor described his character as a regular, happy-go-lucky and good-hearted guy. 20. Chopra played the role of Jhilmil. Basu described Chopra's role as the toughest in the film. 10. In order to prepare for the role, Chopra visited several mental institutions and spent time with autistic people. She said she had to research a little for the role because in India awareness about autism is very low. 21. Chopra told that she had to let go of every inhibition probably that she had as a Hindi film heroine and play Jhilmil without thinking of it. She explained that she needed 2 moments to become Jhilmil because she didn't identify with her character due to difference between her thought and behavior. 22. D. Cruz, who portrayed the narrator and first love interest of the protagonist, said, "Shruti is such a sensitive role to play as she goes to different phases in the film." 23. According to Basu, after Kapoor, Chopra and D. Cruz's characters, Saurabh Shukla's character as Inspector Datta was the most important. Basu described the role as amazing character who makes others cry when he laughs. 24. Filming. Principal photography commenced in March 2011. 25. 26. Barfi was shot between June 2011 and February 2012, mostly in Darjeeling. 27. In March 2011, Basu visited Kolkata to finalize the locations within the city. Filming in Mumbai began on the 20th of March 2011 and continued until May 2011. 28. In June 2011, the cast and crew shot in Darjeeling. 29. In December 2011, some scenes were filmed on the outskirts of Coimbatore, especially Pollachi and Ooty. 30. The scenes in which Kapoor's character is chased by policemen over the rooftops were shot in Kolkata at the end of January 2012. 31. Shooting was completed by April 2012, except for some scenes featuring Chopra. The producers postponed the release from the 13th of July to the 31st of August 2012 as the September 2011 shooting schedule was cancelled and was waiting to be shot. 7.32, however, Basu began working on D. Cruz's dubbing portions by end of April 2012, because D. Cruz was unfamiliar with the Hindi language and wanted to learn it whilst filming. 33. Soundtrack. Main article, Barfi. Soundtrack. The music and background score of the film is composed by Pritam Chakraborty, and lyrics were written by Swanand Kirkire, Ashish Pandit, Nilesh Misra and Saeed Quadri. The soundtrack album has 6 original songs which released on the 9th of August 2012. The soundtrack was influenced by Brazilian Bossa Nova. 34. Priyanka Chopra was supposed to sing a track for the film, but her contract with Universal Music prevented her from taking the offer. 35. The soundtrack album also contains a song titled Fatafati, sung by Pritam Chakraborty, Arijit Singh and Naksh Aziz, which was not be used in the film, but the song was released as a promotional single on YouTube on the 10th of September 2012 with a video which contains some behind-the-scenes footage and the additional vocals are sung by Ranbir Kapoor. The song also has some Bengali lyrics written by Amitabh Bhattacharya. 36. Marketing and release. The official trailer of the film was launched on the 2nd of July 2012 featuring all the actors. It included no dialogue, portraying comedy through gestures and actions, and was well received by critics and audiences. 37. Chopra's character was kept under wraps in the trailers as the makers were not willing to reveal much about her character to increase curiosity among the audiences and was only revealed around the release of the film. Shikha Kapoor, the executive director, marketing, of UTV, explained, "Priyanka plays a very special character in Barfi, so we want to keep her mystery intact. In the first trailer, Barfi, played by Ranbir, will be unveiled. We don't plan to reveal Priyanka until the film releases." 38. Three people are smiling and looking forward. Aliana D. Cruz, Priyanka Chopra and Ranbir Kapoor at a promotional event. UTV Motion Pictures created a YouTube application called The Flavor of Barfi, designed for the marketing the film. The application features Ranbir Kapoor as his character from the film and allows users to type actions, which Kapoor acts out. The application features two zones. One asks users to change Barfi's mood and the other gives users the chance to watch him flirt. 39. The film was promoted in various cities across India. While promoting the film at the Phoenix Mall, Bangalore, the crowds broke through the barricades. 40. Barfi was released on the 14th of September 2012 on 1300 screens in 700 theatres in India. 41. Reliance Home Entertainment released Barfi on DVD and Blu-ray in mid-November 2012 across all regions in a one-disc pack complying with the NTSC format. 42. The DVD and the Blu-ray discs contained bonus content, including making of the film, Fatafati, behind the scenes, and deleted scenes. The video CD version was released at the same time. The exclusive right to broadcast the film was bought by Zee Network and UTV Movies. The deal includes premiere rights of the film along with the several other UTV productions. The rights are for a period of 7 years, consisting the premiere, for both channels, of the film. Zee Network will have multiple runs while UTV Movies will have selected runs rights. The price of the deal was not revealed by the production company. 43. The film is also available on Netflix. 44. In Japan, the film released in August 2014. It was released on 10 screens in 6 Japanese cities, Tokyo, Yokohama, Nagoya, Osaka, Kyoto and Fukuoka. 45. Controversies. On the 12th of September 2012, British manufacturer Murphy Radio claimed that its trademark Murphy Baby logo from its 1970s print advertisements has been used in Barfi without permission. 46. Producer Siddharth Roy Kapoor said that he had received a legal notice from Murphy but said that there is nothing wrong in the intention, as the brand in question has been shown in a very positive light. 47. After the film's release, several blogs and users of social media websites Twitter, Facebook and YouTube accused the director of plagiarism. 48. Media further alleged that Basu had not tried to credit the original sources. Several videos were uploaded to YouTube showing side-by-side comparisons with Hollywood films like Cops, The Adventurer, City Lights, Singin' in the Rain, Project A, The Notebook and Benny and June. They also accused Barfi's music director Pritham of copying the background music from the French film Amelie. 49. Basu defended the film by saying that he was inspired by these works and that Barfi contains an original plot, screenplay, characters and situations. 50. He said that he was paying homages to Keaton and Chaplin. 8. Barfi's Oscar selection for Best Foreign Language Film was criticized because of plagiarism, but Oscar selection committee chief Manju Bora defended the film by saying, Barfi deserves to be sent outside. The selection was a very open process with 3 to 4 rounds of severe discussions and came down to the best film of the final three. 51. Reception. India. A photograph of Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor and Aliana D'Cruz looking forward, smiling and posing for the camera. Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor, and Aliana D'Cruz received widespread praise for their performances in the film. Barfi received widespread critical acclaim upon release, with critics praising the cast, performances, direction, screenplay, cinematography, music and the positive portrayal of physically disabled people. 52. Zee News gave the film 5 out of 5 stars and said, all in all, Anurag Basu's Barfi is a perfect sweet treat for his audience. Like it has been discussed, those filmmakers who have been portraying the handicapped as dull and boring in their films must take a lesson from Barfi. 53. Madhurita Mukherjee of the Times of India gave the film a 4/5 rating and said, Kapoor, in the most challenging performance of his career, leaves us dumbstruck. Without use of conventional crutches of cool catchphrases, dhamakedar dialogue bazi, bare bodies, and other items, he stuns you in every single frame. For Chopra, there's only one word, bravo. In a role where she needs to under-emote, she does so brilliantly, delivering an incredible performance. 54. Roshni Devi of Koimoi said, Barfi leaves you with that warm, cuddly, magical feeling with a few tears to match. It's really worth a watch, and gave it an overall score of 3.5 stars out of 5. 55. Taran Adarsh of Bollywood Hangama gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi is akin to a whiff of fresh air. Its foremost triumph is that it leaves you with a powerful emotion, happiness. 56. Indo-Asian News Service gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi comes as close to being a modern masterpiece as cinematically possible. To miss it would be a crime. To embrace it is to serenade the sublime. 57. Anirudh Guha of Daily News and Analysis rated the film 4 out of 5 and remarked that movie engages you at a personal level, and further added that Barfi cannot be missed. It demands patience, but the payoff is incredible. 58. Pritim D. Gupta of The Telegraph said, the brilliance of Barfi is that it's no story and all storytelling. It's about a director at the top of his game orchestrating terrific talent into a bravura crescendo. Only someone who has showed death the door can open windows to life like this. 59. Filmfare gave the film 4 out of 5 stars and stated, Barfi is that rare film that can make you smile and make you cry in the same scene. Its technical brilliance is only outdone by its emotional complexity and depth. Pritham's music adds a nice silent era charm to this already fantastic story, making it an occasion when words simply aren't enough. 60. Raja Sen of Rediff.com has given 3.5 stars and wrote, Barfi is a well-crafted script with an intriguing back-and-forth narrative, but it all goes south towards the end. 61. Anupama Chopra, writing for Hindustan Times, gave it 3 out of 5 stars and wrote, T. His is a film made with love, bolstered by wonderfully etched vignettes, Kapoor and Chopra's stupendous performances and a gorgeous soundtrack by Pritham. And yet, for me, Barfi was a singularly frustrating experience. There was so much to like, but the film never became more than the sum of its parts. 62. Rajiv Masand of CNNIBN gave 3 out of 5 stars and said, Barfi had the potential to be great cinema, but as it stands, it's a respectable film that's still better than a lot else you're likely to see. 63. On the contrary, Namrata Joshi of Outlook felt that the flashback within flashback narrative gets way too clumsy and turgid, the thriller twist absolutely pointless, appears much too crafted and self-consciously gorgeous, and feels eminently facile and plastic. 64. Overseas. The film received high critical acclaim overseas as well. On the review aggregator website Rotten Tomatoes, 86% of 14 critics' reviews are positive, with an average rating of 7.2/10. 65. Rachel Saltz of the New York Times said, Bollywood isn't afraid to be mawkish. Barfi is at times, though not noticeably more so than most Hindi movies, despite its premise of special lovers with a special lesson to teach. 66. Lisa Sering, The Hollywood Reporter.